2014年，香港学生发起的雨伞运动是香港自回归中国之后最大规模的民主运动。香港人当时希望争取能够有选出代表香港人治港的自主权，参与人数超过10万人。而雨伞运动的发起人之一黄之锋也是运动的主要面孔。美国导演也就以黄之锋这个人物拍摄了 Joshua Teenager vs. Superpower 的纪录片。电影名字可以翻译成黄之锋青少年挑战超级强国，顾名思义，讲述黄之锋虽然年纪轻却有挑战中共的雄心。电影在影展参赛纪录片当中获得世界观众大奖。
I was kind of tapped into this world of teenage revolutionaries, so I had Joshua on my radar. I wasn't familiar with all the ins and outs of his story until I really started to dig in and realized that there was just an incredible storythat was going on, and it was an ongoing thing, which made it a challenge as well for our team to film this, because every time we thought we had reached the end of the film, something new happened in his life, and we realized, oh my God, we got to include that. And so we just kept filming.
我會覺得每一次都是希望去帶來一個奇蹟的發生，將不可能的事變為可能。成立學民思潮的時候，沒想過會有120,000人反國教，爭取普選的時候，沒想過會有雨傘運動。
泰国曼谷一名风光一时的建筑师在事业上走下坡，家庭生活也不再存在欢乐。街上碰到一只他认为是他童年宠物的大象，断然买下大象，决定不顾一切将大象带回乡村大象收容营。这是新加坡华裔导演陈静音的处女作《大笨象 Popeye》。电影被选在影展的第一天举行全球首映，在参赛剧情片中获得世界组最佳剧本。陈静音的灵感来自在泰国居住期间在海边看到的一幕。
The image was so surreal because we were just like on this beach, and then suddenly this group of boys and an elephant came up from nowhere, and then so they were showering him, like, you know, just splashing water on him, and somehow, like, just looking at that image, it I felt happy for them because they looked really like they were enjoying what they were doing, and they really looked completely in the moment.And suddenly, strangely, I felt this sense of loss.
而今年的 Sundance 影展也开设了名为《新气象 New Climate》的电影组别，让和环境问题有关的电影有机会在这个电影节中接触观众。中国纪录片《Plastic China》（塑料王国）。中国有多达25个县以超低价进口全球的塑料垃圾，每年超过100万公吨，经过再循环转为廉价物品。电影带观众看这些垃圾处理厂的环境问题和员工健康受到的相关影响。
事实上，可能正是因为我们的不关心，所以背后的一些秘密我们是不知道的。而事实上，这个垃圾的问题又反过来作用，或者反作用于我们每个人。我想这应该是值得正视的一个话题。
而另外一部中国影片《轻松加愉快》也在影展中获得评审颁发的电影视野大奖。今年的 Sundance 电影节在11天内展出超过220部来自全球各地的原创电影作品。